All right, well, welcome aboard the space station. We've spent how many days here? I don't know, 7 days, 8 days, something like that. We delivered the last pressurized module. We delivered the ELC-4. We did a whole bunch of transfer, and we outfitted the PMM as best we could with the time available. And Scott, it was a pleasure to be up here. We appreciate your hospitality. We appreciate you putting up with us, knocking your stuff off the walls, and generally trashing your station, doubling the number of people. And we appreciate you guys letting us float down to the service module and get in your way as well. And on behalf of the crew, we had a great time. We appreciate the hospitality and enjoyed the crew meals together. And we're going to miss you guys. And so thanks for everything.
Well, I'd like to say that it was a very successful time on board with you guys. We really enjoyed having guests. This is the first group of guests I've had in about 150 days since I've been up here. And we're going to miss you. But most of all, we're going to miss Discovery. And Discovery has been a great ship and has really supported the International Space Station more so than I think any other space shuttle. And we wish her fair winds and following seas. Thank you.
Shuttle and station crews sharing a laugh as they take some final photographs before the shuttle crew members take their leave and will begin to file out of the Destiny module back into the space shuttle. They'll be heading toward this camera view, heading through Node 2 and onto Discovery.
Hey, I just want to let you guys know this is going to be our last shift for your ISS leads. I had Lenny over here a little while ago and taking Katie's comments there. I think we got enough prop on the vehicle to get light speed. We can do this day again. We'll call it 14-1. If you guys are go with that, we'll try.
Well, hey, we're here to support you guys, whatever you want.
I just wanted to take the opportunity before the ISS leads got off console here today. Mr. Lenny will be back with you guys in the morning. But I did want to take an opportunity while we had the whole crew there just to tell everybody it's been an honor and a privilege to work this mission with you. And we really look forward to seeing everybody back on the ground. A couple of folks have asked me recently what I would feel at this moment, and I think the answer is just feel really proud to take Discovery home at the very top of her game, and a lot of that credit goes to the onboard crew. You guys rock.
Yeah, Flight, and, you know, of course, we are really proud of you guys and the amount of teamwork it takes to pull this kind of mission off. It really was an incredible effort on your part, and you know, you guys are really the unsung heroes in this, and you know, it's so much going on simultaneously. I would imagine these last couple of days, not today, but the day before and the day before that, were probably the two most busiest days in the space station program. So, you know, all your folks that have worked on this in both programs, shuttle and station, should be very proud.
We copy. You guys have a safe trip home. We'll see some of you sooner, but we're looking forward to seeing all of y'all back on terra firma.
Hey, and Royce, from Steve, you know, I watched you work this mission from the very beginning, I watched your team work it. I watched you guys knock down every little problem and every little detail flat. I watched the planners replan this mission for 4 months with varying timelines as well as the shuttle side, and I just got to say it's real testimony to your team and your leads and all that you did to keep us organized, keep us focused on the tasks at hand and get it done that made this a success. We were just the executors, but you guys are the ones that really put this all together. So thank you from both crews for all that you do.
Thank you.
final handshakes and hugs as the Space Shuttle Discovery crew members get ready to leave the International Space Station. Shuttle Commander Steve Lindsay and Station Commander Scott Kelly both expressing their thanks to the ground team, to lead station flight director Royce Renfrew. Our camera view now is from inside the Harmony module, looking forward. The hatch in the background leads into a permanent pressurized mating adapter number 2, which is attached to the Space Shuttle's orbiter docking system. And that is that will be the exit for all of the folks in the blue shirts. And from this view that is pointed down into the transfer path between the two vehicles, you can see over Scott Kelly's shoulder the shuttle crew members moving back onto their vehicle. Once everyone's on the right side of the hatches, Kelly and Paolo Nespoli will be working to close the hatch that we see down beyond Steve Lindsay. That's the forward hatch on the PMA. Lindsay and Al Drew will be working on the shuttle side of that interface, closing the hatch to the orbiter docking system. And we've just seen Commander Scott Kelly close the forward hatch on the pressurized mating adapter number 2. That hatch closed at 3:11 p.m. Central Time. Still a number of steps for the station crew members to be working through on this side. And of course, the shuttle crew is working on their side of that hatch, closing the hatch on the orbiter docking system. The last of the steps for the shuttle crew in this hatch closing procedure is the one where they actually close the orbiter docking system hatch and lock it.
Please don't leave it in the PMA, and we'll find a permanent home for it a little later.
And so that makes the hatch closure time on the orbiter docking system hatch 3:23 Central this afternoon. That came after the hatch on the station side of the interface was closed at 3:11 for a total hatch opening time on this mission of 7 days, 23 hours, and 55 minutes.